my dear students. Now in this video, let us move on to the next topic. How does the e-commerce work? In our previous video, we have seen what is e-commerce and what are the different technologies and services which are being used in e-commerce. Now before I start with the explanation, I would just like to explain this, some of the terminology. Now this e-commerce example, what I'm going to explain is about whenever you make an online payment, if you purchase any product and when you are making an online payment through the credit card transaction, then certain various steps are being included. Almost 9 steps are being included. When you know through the card, when your credit card, when you make a transaction, who all are the entities who are involving in the transaction? How your credit card details are being carried to the merchant's bank processor? That means the owner. Merchant is nothing but the shopkeeper. Understood? Customer in the sense it's we. How your card will make a contact to the merchant's bank processor, and how they will access your details, and how the money will be transferred to the merchant's bank account. So this is what is this e-commerce working all about. Okay. So merchant means the shopkeeper, customers means the we, and there is one more terminology, that is NMA Pay, that is National Merchants Association Payment. That is this, it is acting as a gateway between the customer and the bank. That is the National Merchants Association Payment. Initially, in the first step, the merchant will submit on behalf of the customer. The merchant will submit the credit card transaction to the this National Merchants Association Payment Gateway on behalf of the customer via the secured connection through the wireless device. Secured connection, why you need it? See, you can see the internet is locked here. That means encryption is needed, because you will be sending all the bank transaction, bank details you will be sending along with the PIN. They'll ask you to enter the PIN also, and whenever you are making an online payment, right, through your card. So at the time, the hacker or the cracker, they may steal your data. So in order to provide the security, when the merchants will provide all your credit card details, it will go to the NMA through the secured connection. Now in the step 2, you can see the sequence number is also there. In step 2, what happened? This NMA Pay will receive that secure connection and passes that information to the merchant bank's processor via secure connection. Okay, because you need to transfer the amount to this person's bank account, right? So all the details will make contact with the merchant's bank's processor. It will pass that information. So and so amount, so and so product has been purchased, so much amount should be, it should be added in the merchant's account. Correct. Moving on to the third step. Here, NMA will submit, okay? The National Merchant Association will submit the transactions, whatever the details, it will submit to the credit card network. What is this credit card network? It's a kind of a system that will manage, process, clear the settlement of credit card transactions. All the credit card transaction will be handled by this credit card network. This, in the fourth step, the credit card network will route that transaction to the customer's credit card issuing bank. This is the customer card issuing bank, in order to validate whether you are the genuine user or no. Okay, this, in the step 5, this customer credit card issuing bank, that maybe he's having an Axis Bank credit card, and he is having SBI. So this customer credit issuer bank, in the sense it is going to access the Axis Bank here. So the customer credit card issuing bank will approve or decline the transaction based upon the customer available fund. Depending upon when they are making credit card transaction also, they'll see certain limitation will be there, no? So depending upon that, this bank may approve or decline the transaction based upon the customer's available funds, and then passes that results. If it is approved, then it will pass the result back to the credit card network itself. Yes, they are eligible to make this kind of payment. Then the credit card will relay those, you know, transaction results to the National Merchants Association. That means what? This credit card will contact back to what? That is the National Merchant Association. The results will go for this National Merchant Association itself to the sixth one. Okay. Seventh step, what happened? This National Merchant Association will release the transaction results to the NMA payment. So this NMA pay will send the again results back to whom? It will send the result back to this gateway saying yes, they are eligible. Okay, here all the validation process will take place, whether he is a genuine user, whether the merchant is genuine user. Okay, so when it will come in the seventh step, at the eighth step, what? This NMA pay, okay, will store the transaction results and send them to the customer or the merchant. So this step actually completes the authorization process all in about just in 3 seconds. See, firstly the merchant will send an all their credit card details to NMA pay in the first step. NMA pay will forward that data to the merchant's bank processor, because in his account the data has to, I mean amount has to be transferred. They will contact his bank. Your credit card details will contact the credit card interchange network, where it will manage all the credit card transaction. Then that request will go to the customer's credit card issuer bank. This bank will have the authority to check whether you are eligible to make such kinds of transaction. Authorization, it will check whether you are an authenticated person to make such kinds of transaction. If so, it will send the result back to the credit card network to the NMA pay. NMA pay will send it will store the details, a copy of that, and then send a copy to the merchant's business. Then the merchant business will say that yes, we have been connected, the authorization is there. Okay, we are the genuine users. So all this kind of connection happens just in 3 seconds. We'll not even get to know it. In the final steps, what happened? The National Merchant Association will send an appropriate, then this merchant will enter an amount. So 1,000, maybe it will ask you enter the amount to pay. Then you will enter the amount as 1,000. So that request again will be sent to NMA pay. NMA will send an appropriate fund transaction to the directly to the, it will send to the, through this merchant, it will send to the credit card. Credit card network, which passes that funds to the merchant's bank account. Okay, NMA pay will send that whatever 1,000 rupees, that data it will send to the credit card interchange through the credit card network. You know, the fund will be transferred to this merchant bank account. The bank will then deposit that fund into this, you know, merchant's account. This step is known as settlement process, and all the transaction funds are being deposited in the merchant's bank account within 24 to 48 hours. So this is exactly how the e-commerce works. Okay, moving on to the next one, that is the types of e-commerce, which is very interesting one. In types of e-commerce, we have 4 different types, that is B2B, business to business, business to consumer, consumer to business, and consumer to consumer. Business to business, in the sense, here the product or the information or the exchange of service will be done between the one business to another business partners. Maybe they are the manufacturers. Any business that may takes place between the manufacturers and the wholesalers. Manufacturers are one who are producing the product, who are developing the product, and then they'll give to the wholesaler. Wholesalers, then they will, you know, start distributing, you know, selling the products to the customers. Any business that is between the, or exchange of information, goods or the products between one business with the another business partners, then I can call it as the business to business, okay, type of e-commerce. Rather than directly selling it to the consumer, the manufacturers and the wholesalers will exchange the products, then it is called as business to business. Example I can give here is ebay.com. okay, moving on to the next, that is business to consumer. In business to consumer, here the exchange of services or the selling of the product or the information happens between the business to a consumer. That is business to consumer. Any exchange of products or selling of the information or the services, that is between the business to consumer. Example, Flipkart.com or Amazon.com. So business to consumer, direct, it's a kind of a website business that it's a website which are holding, showing certain products in them. So directly you'll see the product, okay, make an online transaction, and the product will be directly will be given from the Flipkart to the consumer directly. This kind of business is called as business to consumer. Understood? Moving on to the third one, that is consumer to business. Consumer to business in the sense, here consumer will directly contact the business vendors. Business vendors in the sense the intermediate person. Consumer, maybe consumers are the, you know, consumers are the product holders. Or just an example I'll give. If a person has designed any product and he has to sell it to the market, directly he cannot go and sell it. He will contact the business vendors first by posting their project. Maybe through the website they may post their project and they will bid. Okay, they'll put certain budget. Then the needy companies, they will review whatever the works have been put by that particular customer. They will review it. If they feel good, they will contact that particular customer. The business vendors will contact with that particular customer and then they will have the further business. If the consumers reviews all the bids, consumer also see how much this business vendor is charging for me, whether I'm getting any benefit from that business. The consumer will review all its bids, then it may select certain companies for further having business. Just an example I'll give. If he's a photographer, professional photographer, he will click certain good images and he will post it online. There will be so many business companies will be looking for the good photographers for their, you know, companies for the working and all. These, you know, companies or the business person, okay, they will bid certain value, so and so amount. They will be bid for that particular photographer. Then the photographer will look all, it will, he will review all the bids made by the different companies. Whichever he will feels good, he will select that particular company and then further proceeds with the business. This kind of, you know, business is called as consumer to business. Example, guru.com, freelancer.com, any blogger or any photographer. This is nothing but consumer to business. Usually consumer will be the developer here. He will design the product, then make it, you know, known to the different business vendor. They will contact the business vendors by bidding. And they will put a budget and then they'll contact those particular companies. Companies will look at their work. They will put certain bidding for that. So then consumer will review all those bids. Whichever he feels it good with that particular company, he will proceed his business. Moving on to the last type. That's a consumer to consumer. So here electronic commerce will take place between the consumers itself. Like the, it will provide an internet facilitated form of business, like, you know, OLX.com. In OLX.com, consumer to consumer they are providing. And then one more is coming, that cars.com or something like that, where the directly the seller and the buyer will directly have the communication over the internet. Then they'll see the product and then directly business takes place between the consumer to consumer to consumer. Such kind of, you know, type of, you know, business is called as the consumer to consumer, that is C2C. I hope the working of e-commerce and the different types of e-commerce are clear to you. Okay. So moving on to some of the advantages of the e-commerce here. Advantages of e-commerce and the implementation. The first is advantages. It's easier entry into the new markets. It is easier to entry into new markets, especially geographically remote markets for the companies of all sizes and the location. Yes, because of the online transaction, there are so many vendors that had come into existence over the online and making their products known to the public. it's easier to enter into the markets because of the internet facility. If we had not had any kind of internet facility, then the public wouldn't, or consumer wouldn't come to know what are the different products, what are the different kinds of, maybe if it is in clothing or any product, what are the different types are available. Then we would never come to know about those, such kinds of kind of business, irrespective of their geographical location. No matter they certain business may vendors may come from the rural or the urban areas, irrespective of any kind of locations, irrespective of any business type they are having. If they make it available their business products over the online, it is easier to enter into the market. Moving on to the second one, application creates a new markets through the ability to easily and economical rate potential for the customers. It creates a kind of a new market. See, nowadays because of this lockdown and all, so many business vendors are making they are advertising their products in the Facebook, Insta, different kinds of social media, where they are even providing the economical rate for the customers also, in order to attract customers. So once the customers are able to buy their products, then easily they can be have the trustworthy, isn't it? Then they will, next time onwards, they don't think for the they don't go for the second chance to think whether this website is a trustworthy or no. So they are even providing the economical rate in order to attract the customers. Moving on to the third advantage, that's a global participation. Obviously, Some business vendors are providing the live videos of their products, right? They're uploading into FB and all. And global part, for example, other website I can give, Flipkart, Amazon and all. All the products, irrespective of any product, let it be mobile, clothing or whatever the products are, all the customers, irrespective of their location, they can able to view it. Right, they can buy it, no matter whether it is in the different countries also, we can place an online order. That is nothing but the global participation. It will be both by the business vendors also, both at the time of customer. Business people can upload in particular website, they can upload their product, no matter they belong to the different country. And the customers who are want to purchase it also might be from different country. So like this global participation may takes place in the one of the advantage in the e-commerce. The next is the optimization of resources. This means optimization means it helps for the improvement of your website in order to attract the customers. They will turn those visitors into the customers by providing the useful information about your product description might be good in your website, right? Easy access of your website may attract the customer. Certain websites are there which the lookout will not be that good, Amazon in terms of clothing, it's not that easily. Whereas in Myntra, Flipkart.com, okay, their lookout and their ease of access is very good, and similar products automatically you will be able to see. This is nothing but optimization of resource. They are improving their website by applying the different methods, by providing the each and every detail about the product descriptions, whatever they upload, advertise for. Then moving on to the next one, reduce time to complete business transaction, particularly from delivery to payment. This means what? Obviously, whenever you make an online payment, you will be waiting for your, you will be waiting for your product delivery, isn't it? Within no time. So you have, whenever there is any product over the website in e-commerce, they should make sure that they have a minimum time. Within minimum period of time, the product should be delivered to the customer in order to make the customer satisfaction. So many times you see the reviews in certain Flipkart.com and all, just receive the delivery product just within 3 to 4 days or something like that. That is nothing but they are very much satisfied because they have very less time in delivering the particular product. That is why it is reduce the time to complete the business transaction, particularly from the delivery to the payment. Once the payment is done, make sure that the delivery should be very fast. That is there in case of e-commerce. That is why most of the people rely on online rather than going and buying outside. nowadays almost we are into completely in the form of e-commerce, we are extensively being used. Furthermore, advantages of e-commerce we will discuss in our next video. Take care of yourself, students. Thank you.